Animated morning, dear students. Let's come to today's English class. You're all welcome. How are you today? I hope you're all doing good and you get refreshed to listen to this class. Today we will go through the poetry, and this poem is written by Edward Lear. Edward Lear is one of the great poets in the literature of English, and he's known well for his literary nonsense. What does it mean by literary nonsense? It means he finds fun in every object, in everything of the nature, and mostly he prefers to write much on regarding certain funny things, okay, imaginary things. Okay, in this poem, The Duck and the Kangaroo, he would like to bring about certain truth about the duck and the kangaroo, how they have become friends, on what reason, it's been such a suitable time for them to get involved with each other in the great friendship. Okay, the duck and the kangaroo. Okay, come to page number, it's 97. All of you must open page number 97. As I always tell you one thing, what is that? You need to hold your pencil and open your textbooks and listen to me and open up your minds also. Unless you get ready to listen to teacher's words, you may not find the truth or you may not enjoy the lesson. Okay, today's poem is such an interesting, such a funniest poem, and let's go through it. Two friends, who are those? Duck and the kangaroo, are about to set out on a long pleasure trip. Where they wanted to go? They wanted to go on a pleasure trip. The kangaroo, though happy to carry the duck all the way on the tip of its tail, is wary of her wet feet. What will the duck do to make the kangaroo feel comfortable over land and the sea? Let us find out how they go about. Actually, kangaroo has no objection to take the duck at the tip of its tail and move on the land as well as on the sea. But who has got the great objection, you know? The duck itself. Because duck feels guilt about its wet feet. And duck is the one who lives both on water and the land. But most probably and preferably it likes to live in water. So, because of constantly living in water or in the water body, its feet is always found wet. Let us go through this poem. And here, kangaroo has got an objection. At the beginning, it has no objection. Then he had seen the duck and the position and the condition of it. It has laid the certain conditions to the duck in order to take its pleasure trip on the back of the kangaroo. Kangaroo was very friendly with the duck and the duck as well. And duck to make to kangaroo feel comfortable. What will the duck do to make the kangaroo comfortable? Even in our friendship, we need to think about the person's or our friend's comfortability. Okay, in friendly way of doing things, or in our friendship, sometimes certain things of our friends also would object. Okay? Due to our intimacy, due to having good intimacy among or between our friends, sometimes we cannot tell them anything elaborately, but we do have certain objections. If you are a real friend of your friend, definitely you could tell them how they need to bring changes in their character. Okay, if you really wanted to get the welfare, if you really wanted to see the welfare of your friend, you need to give certain instructions. You need to tell your friend in a friendly manner whatever the changes that he or she could do. Okay, she could bring about. Here also, kangaroo has no objection with the duck, but duck, he himself had got some objection. But he wanted to give comfortability. What he wants to give to the kangaroo? Comfortability. Finally, duck would like to give him comfortability. Okay, over land and sea, they are about to take their journey. Okay, on their journey, they are not supposed to have any problems. It's a, such a long trip. It's a long pleasure trip. You please underline both the characters, duck and the kangaroo. Underline the word pleasure trip and wet feet of the duck. Weary. Weary means what? W-A-R-Y. Tiring. Okay, get tired. And comfortability or comfortable. And these are all the words so far we have come across. Here in the picture you can see the kangaroo is carrying the duck at the tip of its tail. T-A-I-L must not be pronounced as tail. It should be pronounced as tail. N-A-I-D, you have to pronounce it as made. It is not made. Is that understood? So when it comes to pronunciation, even if you are not well aware of the pronunciation, you need to learn. Okay? So world widely acceptable pronunciation, you need to learn. Especially we have British English and American English. British English is full of instructions and full of rules and regulations. But American English is not like that. Okay, Americans' English is according to their own comfortability, according to their own convenience they speak. But when it comes to British English, they have got some stipulated rules and regulations and certain instructions. Is that clear, children? Let us move on. My first stanza begins like this. Said the duck to the kangaroo, "Good gracious, have you hopped over the fields and the water too? As if you never would stop, my life is bored in this nasty pond. And I long to go out in the world beyond. I wish I could hop like you," said the duck to the kangaroo. This is a conversation takes place between the duck and the kangaroo. Okay, who is the speaker started his speech? That's duck. Duck started speaking to kangaroo. "Good gracious, you are very lucky." Good gracious in the sense, oh, you are very lucky. You are such a fortunate being on this earth. Why, you know, you can hop. In case of me, either I can swim, or I can paddle, or I can walk on the land. Actually, I think you might have observed the way the duck walks on the land. Duck is a heavy bird. It's not a bird like other birds. It cannot fly. It is a flightless bird. Duck and the hen. Okay, cock and hen. These are also flightless birds. F-L-I-G-H-T-L-E-S-S. Flightless birds means the birds which they cannot fly. Okay, the light birds, their bones are filled with air and the feathers also could help them to fly freely in the air. But it doesn't happen with duck. Okay, duck is a heavy bird. Even when it is walking, it looks so funny because due to its heavy, okay, it is too stout, you know. It cannot walk freely. Okay, it's too heavy to walk. Good gracious means, hey, you lucky, how you hop? Oh, how nicely you're hopping. You hop, but I walk. And I can paddling in the water, okay? Walking heavily in the water. Because the water, the means will not let you take your move quickly. That is called paddling. Okay, the duck paddles in the mud and also it paddles in the water. And sometimes the duck, if the water body is too big or heavy in the sense, or too huge in a sense, it can also swim. It can swim, it can paddle, it can walk. Duck has three different qualities when it comes to its movement. When it comes to kangaroo, it can hopping and leaping. Okay. Over the fields and the water too. How does this kangaroo hop? It can hop over the fields and over the water. So, fields and water, it's not a problem for kangaroo. It can manage both. It can manage field as well as the water. It can hop over the fields and it can hop over the water as if you never would stop. When I look at you so closely, I always have a great surprise because I think whether you would stop. It means the duck always have a great surprise when it looks at the kangaroo whether it could stop, as if it would never stop. Okay, it looks as if it never stop, means continuously, constantly. Okay, it looks as if it can hop. My life is bored in this nasty pond. See, look at me. My life in this water or in this pond is boring. What is the name of that water water body? It's pond. Okay, and it is too nasty. Nasty means dirty, ugly, not fit, not happy with it. It's a nasty pond. I live in this pond which is nasty. It's quite boring for me. How does the duck feel to live in the pond? It's such a nasty pond. The life in such a nasty pond is really boring. It's really boring. And I want to go out. Where did this duck like to go out? Like to go? He would like to go out. So whenever the duck gets the thought of living its condition, the condition of its living, it's really not at all nice. It's unable to enjoy the world. It hadn't seen anything except the pond. So it always has one thought in its mind. What is that? He wants to go on a pleasure trip. How could he go? He couldn't go easily. So that's why on whom he was depending? He was depending directly on the kangaroo. He was depending directly on the kangaroo. And he thought that the kangaroo would be the help of him. And I long to go. What does it mean by long? Wish. What does it mean by long? Long means wish to go out in the world. He wants to see the world beyond. What's there in the world? I never knew. I just wanted to go out of this pond and explore the world. How does the world look? How does it look? I have no good idea. I think the world might look so beautiful. So let me come along with you. Please carry me on the tip of your tail, it's asked. I wish, long is nothing but wishing. I wish I could hop like you. Will it happen? Suppose you and me would think that we would like to fly like a bird in the sky. It never happened because we are humans, they are birds. You cannot swim like a fish in the water because you are not a fish, you are a human. The duck cannot hop like a kangaroo because duck is a duck, kangaroo is a kangaroo. Okay, the characteristic features of duck never come to kangaroo. The characteristic features of this kangaroo never attributed or never come to duck. It should know the reality. Duck is not knowing the reality of its life. I wish I could hop like you, said the duck to the kangaroo. So finally, the duck conveyed its wish to kangaroo. The first stanza, it is consisting how many lines? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. There are 8 lines in this stanza. This first stanza is giving a clear information about the duck and the kangaroo. Their friendship has become so tight that each one of them are expressing their wish to each other, especially the duck. The remaining part of this poem will be learned in the next episode. Until we meet again, goodbye. And I request everyone to go through this poem in advance so that whenever I'm teaching you, you can take an active part in the poem. Thank you, children. Bye-bye.